In my over 20 years of experience in financial services and advising millionaires and multimillionaires, and of course having accumulated millions of dollars worth of assets myself, I realized that there are some common lifestyle traps that prevent people from being able to save and invest for their financial future. And unlike the vast majority of people, if you are somebody who is ambitious and wants to make sure that you never run out of money, you want to accumulate enough wealth for your future, you're going to have to avoid these traps that I'm going to talk about. Now, in one of my previous videos, I talk about the fact that if you are under the age of 45, you need to be investing a minimum of 12% of your annual income. And if you're over the age of 45, you need to look at investing a minimum of 15% of your annual income to give yourself any chance of being able to accumulate the type of net worth which will replace a good percentage of your income when you retire. Now, if you haven't watched that video, I urge you to check out that video where I explain why it's important for you to be allocating a percentage of your annual income towards investments every year. And it's never too early to start. The earlier you start, the better it is for you. Now, these lifestyle traps that most people unfortunately get caught up in prevent them from being able to put that money aside. And let's talk about what those are. The first common lifestyle trap that prevents people from being able to save and invest money for their future is to buy or rent in a main capital city close to all the hustle and bustle, and that typically comes at a premium price. A lot of people want to enjoy that seductive lifestyle of being around cafes and restaurants and the hustle and bustle, and they want to be around entertainment centers and shopping centers. But unfortunately, what happens is they end up living that lifestyle very temporarily, because once they do get older, they find that they have no ability to sustain that lifestyle because they haven't been putting money aside regularly. You see, when you're buying in a main capital city, especially in one of the main centers where all the hustle and bustle is, the land price or even the rent tends to be a lot higher. And what that means is that a lot of your income, a good percentage of your income, maybe 50% of your income, is going towards just housing costs. And that disables your ability to be able to put money aside on a regular basis. The second lifestyle trap is to buy expensive cars. Now, I love expensive cars and I like nice cars, but the thing is, I've only started to invest in those types of things once I made sure that there was enough money being put aside for investments. So after you have created wealth, or if you have a great plan and you're regularly putting a percentage of money aside for savings and investments, you can go and buy a nice luxury car. But if you buy a nice luxury car before you invest, you'll find that again, you have no money to be able to put money aside regularly for savings and investments. The third is to spend a lot of time eating out, buying takeaway coffees, going to fancy restaurants. Again, this will give you a temporary feeling of success, but you're the only person who comes back and looks at their bank account and sees that there is no money and your net worth is not increasing. And that can have a debilitating effect on your financial confidence. So minimize spending money on coffees and lunches and things like that, because again, it's just going to give you a very temporary high when you're with your friends, but in the long term, it's not going to make you feel good. The fourth one is to buy designer clothes. Now, designer clothes again will make you feel like, you know, you're successful, but again, the novelty wears out very, very quickly. It is better for you to buy well-fitted clothes that are high quality. And even if you buy designer clothes, the thing is, a lot of people get addicted to buying designer clothes and accessories, and they keep spending a lot of their disposable income towards these things. Again, making it very difficult for them to be putting money aside for savings and investments. Look, the fact is, no matter what you do, you've got to find a way to be able to allocate at least 12 to 15% of your annual income towards savings and investments to give yourself any chance of accumulating the type of net worth that is going to replace a percentage of your income. So be aware of these common traps. They're very common, they're very prevalent, and unfortunately, majority of the middle class has bought into them. The fact is, you want to be wealthy, not just look wealthy. And for that, you're going to have some disciplines, and you're going to have to be very mindful of these lifestyle traps that can disable your ability to create true wealth. So here is what I want you to do. I want you to write down which lifestyle trap is impeding your ability to be able to put money aside, and then make a commitment over the next 90 days to halve that cost at a very minimum, and over the next 180 days to eliminate that cost altogether, so that you can increase your savings and the money that you can allocate for investing.